guys, and welcome to the WWE Fastlane Predictions video. I'm here with Rex Jericho High and Chris Collins.
What's up?
We're here to give you our predictions on WWE Fastlane. So first off is the pre-show, which is for the United States Championship match. It's a 2 out of 3 falls match. So basically, it's like a 3 stages of hell match. Champion Kalisto versus Alberto Del Rio. Now, my own opinion, I think Kalisto should be remaining champion here. But I can honestly see, like, some part of the League of Nations actually interfering in this match. So, your thoughts, Lawrence?
It's 6-2-3 is really, because they're both like, I'd stick Kalisto up over it, because that's not my... I'll get bored of that match, I'll just pick away.
Alright, Kalisto for me and Kalisto for you, Chris?
Kalisto for me, because for one thing, is Alberto Del Rio really worthy of that United States Championship? Because for me, I just think he's a complete jackass.
Okay, alright. Next, and this will be the main event, the triple threat match for the number one contender spot for the WWE World Heavyweight Championship at WrestleMania 32, which is Dean Ambrose versus Roman Reigns versus Brock Lesnar with Paul Heyman. Now, honestly enough, I had a chat with one of my mates here, and we actually said Brock Lesnar, reason being for it, is because Roman Reigns and Dean Ambrose could actually team up against Brock Lesnar, take him out, make sure that he's like injured and all that, then they could face each other, and then once they're worn out, Brock Lesnar could come in and then take them to Suplex City and F5 one of them, and then win the match, and then go on to WrestleMania 32 to face Triple H for the World Heavyweight Championship, which Triple H didn't deserve to win at the Royal Rumble.
Yes, he did. He's a veteran.
Yeah.
I'm picking Roman Reigns because it's so predictable. They'll just give it to him like they usually do.
Right, for my point of view is, Brock Lesnar, he has had some problems with the Wyatt family interfering in some of his matches over recent times. So I think I can, with this being like no DQ, I can actually see the Wyatt family interrupting this match. And I think Brock Lesnar may have a feud with Bray Wyatt leading up to WrestleMania.
Yeah.
And match. I can actually see Dean Ambrose turn heel on Roman Reigns after when Reigns pins Ambrose. So I'm going to go for a Roman Reigns win.
Bray Wyatt, you just see him with Bray Wyatt when that other match, that means it's possible.
Alright. Alright, next is the Divas Championship match, which is Charlotte, who was the champion, with Ric Flair, versus Brie Bella.
I said Brie Bryan.
Yeah, because she's married to Daniel Bryan. You said that she was actually going to retire now, wasn't she?
She said she's leaving when...
She's going to retire.
If Daniel Bryan leaves.
But if this was her final match, I would have Brie Bella actually win. Because then it would make a big impact.
But that's to keep Brie Bella in. But I'll say Charlotte.
But I'm seeing Charlotte then as well. I'm seeing Charlotte now, but I reckon that she might lose it at WrestleMania 32.
Yeah.
And I'm thinking that opponent might actually be Sasha Banks.
Yeah. That's what I would love to see at WrestleMania 32.
Okay, next one.
Alright, next one is a Divas Tag Team match. Becky Lynch and Sasha Banks versus Team Bad, which is Naomi and Tammy Snuka.
And is it trying to be Team Left?
Team Left, yeah. Anyway, I'm going to say Becky Lynch and Sasha Banks are actually going to pick up the victory, because obviously Sasha Banks, a good heel in NXT, and Becky Lynch, she's just really good in the ring.
Yeah.
Well, as Naomi and Tammy are not pretty much like a much of a hit now, to be honest with you.
They're more like the Jobber Divas.
So the only two decent ones that are in there is Becky Lynch and Sasha Banks.
And Sasha Banks has only just recently turned face.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, she's actually really good. But Lawrence, your opinion?
I say Sasha's team. I'm not saying Becky Lynch, fuck Becky Lynch, and important. Sasha's important.
So we're all going for Becky Lynch and Sasha Banks on that one? Yep, that's good. Alright, next one, I cannot believe this.
I think that's predictable.
I can't believe that KO is now the new Intercontinental Championship, right?
It's so predictable.
You know what? Ever since he lost it at TLC, he's been obsessed with it. We get it. You lost at TLC, right? You can't take your loss seriously. Do you know what who he's trying to become like? He's trying to become like a Rusev. You know when he lost his US championship at WrestleMania? He had an obsession with it.
See, to me, everyone's like, we do the playoff. It's like, Seth Rollins is supposed to be the new Triple H. No, Seth Rollins is, Shawn Michaels. They try to see Seth Rollins is Shawn Michaels. What's wrong? It's because Seth Rollins is Triple H. Dolph Ziggler is Shawn Michaels. And some of his own is going to be the new one. He's going to be passed to the new one. He's going to be the next one. So it's the same with Roman Reigns and John Cena. They're the same.
All right. Well, we're getting off topic. Mm-hmm. But this is the Intercontinental Championship match. Kevin Owens, who was the champion, for God's sake, he shouldn't have been, versus Dolph Ziggler. Now, you know what? I can honestly say Kevin Owens retaining the title because he's just won it back. He's obviously not. He's going to retain it. He's going to retain it.
It's going to be too predictable.
He's just going to retain it. So, we're all going for KO.
Yeah.
Next one
is a tag team match. A six-man tag match. Ryback, The Big Show and Kane versus the Wyatt family.
I can think I can pick who's winning at that one.
The Wyatt family?
Yes.
I can see that.
They're going to choke them out because they've got the strongest man there.
Yeah, Braun Strowman.
If they've got Braun Strowman in their team, I think this is going to be like an easy win for the Wyatt family.
Yeah. So it's just too predictable. But like, what did you say? You said that they could use them another big guy like in there.
Yeah.
Like if they had him another big guy, could they have taken out the Wyatt family?
Because Ryback is useless in the ring.
Because for one thing, if anyone's going to take on Braun Strowman in that team, leave that to the Big Show.
Mm-hmm. You know what? Me and my friends were having a discussion, and do you know who we said should face Braun Strowman?
Who?
Brock Lesnar. Because think about it, he's equal to him.
The problem. No,
he knocked him out of the Royal Rumble.
He is, but there's a problem.
What?
If you realised he couldn't pick him up, all he could do was knee him. He was doing his knees on him. He couldn't knock him down with an needle. But he managed to get him out of the ring though.
He eliminated him from the Royal Rumble. But Brock Lesnar is his equal.
The only people managed to get him off his feet so far, Strowman off his feet so far, has actually been Undertaker and King. They're the only two people that managed to do it.
That's because it was a double choke slam, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was. Only two people to get him off his feet.
Because Big Show, Kane and Undertaker together. Yeah. Larger than Strowman.
And then last match.
And the last match, this is really good, that's this, because there's been a feud between them ever since he came in back into the WWE. Not that many people know this, but Lawrence, you've told me that AJ Styles has been in the WWE.
Yes, he has, back in 2002.
But back when it was known as the WWF.
A lot of people don't remember.
Right, so this is AJ Styles versus Chris Jericho. So, who are you going to go Styles. For? Because I know how much you like Y2J.
I love Y2J, but Styles.
You love Y2J.
I love Styles.
Right. I'm seeing Styles M as well.
I wouldn't say Chris Jericho in this match because he's got the experience in WWE, but I'm going to say AJ Styles because he's like the new kid on the block.
On the veteran, anyway.
Well, AJ Styles, he's been in WCW, WWA, TNA, and now he's came back in the WWE. Mm-hmm. But guess what? He was also in that five-star wrestling that happened in Newcastle. Mm-hmm. And apparently, from what somebody was telling me about, it was a pretty boring match that he had.
Sometimes yes, sometimes no, depending on what his opponent is. It's his opponent.
So basically, I'm going to say in this match, unfortunately, Chris Jericho, I'm sorry I have to say this, but I'm going to go with AJ Styles.
Mm-hmm. AJ Styles, alright. So, there you have it. But we've all said, our own things about these predictions. Let us know in the comments section what your predictions are actually going
to
be.
And I'd just love to give like a big shout out to Gav, who is actually a big fan of Dean 448 Vlogs.
Yeah,
also like to give out a shout out to Gav's other mate as well, which is Ross Johnston. So I hope you like his vlog, guys.
Yep, everybody's going to be watching this, and also, with that being said, peace!
Peace out.
That's my business, baby.